It is my firm conviction, through a historical analysis of the few years of Christianity in Nigeria, about 100 years, or a little more in most parts, that Christianity began to deteriorate and collapse in Nigeria the moment some Christian preachers and ministers, some of them Catholic priests, started telling the people, especially those who were suffering, that believing in Christ will bring breakthrough, miracles, and end of your sufferings. Iburu ha na onye otu Kristi, iwere Jesus ka onye nzọpụta gị. If you accept Jesus in your life as your personal savior, nsogbu gị niile na. And these people claimed to be ministers of the gospel of Christ. And they were telling the people, my God is not a poor God. My God is not a suffering God. My Jesus is no longer on the cross. Christians were believed, made to believe, that Christianity worked like Okite and Egombute. And especially if you brought money to the pastor or preacher or to the priest in the name of tithe or offering or seed sowing, and if you said some prayers, even penance for sin, even fasting for discipline and help of the poor, they were all made instruments of breakthrough, selfishness. And Christians, poor Christians, believed that. And money started pouring in. These men and women became powerful, very rich, and arrogant. Under nobody's control, they amassed wealth, built elite schools and universities, established businesses and factories, and became large employers of labor. Some of them acquired private jets. Those who felt they couldn't use private jets would just call one member. Osebro asigi wetere a foreigner. The Lord wants a foreigner from you. Evutere a jeep. Sorry. That was when our church started decaying. Yes, the number was growing, but the number that was growing was the number of pagan churchgoers, not Christians. The Nigeria Mehena Goma Odo Aneja Goma Kamije Wotodo Iwote Kandro Nshegbe Eja Goma Kamije Wote Nshegbe Iwote Incense Iyaza Jagom, Kamije Wote, Iwote Olive Oil. And if it does not happen the way they told you it will happen, it is always your fault, not theirs. No kind. And honestly, many people received miracles. Why? Let me tell you clearly. If I decide to become a criminal and a thief and a 419er and a Yahoo Yahoo and gather all of you around me and tell you that whatever you ask the Lord in his name, he will grant you, and all of you gather around me in my church or in my house, if you pray with faith, God will answer your prayer in spite of the fact that I'm a criminal. But the fact that God answers your prayer in my presence does not make me a saint. I remain the thief. Don't be deceived. Chukwu anaghị ajụ na ya azaghị ekpere ụmụ ya maka na ha enọrọ bụ onye oshije ekpe.
Maganehe norbonye wayoje ikpe.
Some, I don't ever say all. There are many honest, passionate disciples of Christ who are advancing the cause of the gospel and of the cross.
Those who know not, it's not about this world. No bro makihe nko wa.
Yes,
ige nweta ngozi nke Chukwu no wa, but not according to your command, not according to his will. Many of them. But a lot more now, a lot more people now have become pure cheats and businessmen and women who parade themselves as ministers of the gospel.
Aga ejije satimgbere ufodu na anoru ni mahwa gine mepe ulo uka ha ya pastor oga be gbute eke shop onye omuno na onicha mobe nugu mobe lagos mobe abuja mana onwere pastor na aro onu ya church na nsika mobe nubula ho mobe nelugu esik ndoka na igbule.
Why do we expect things to be better when nobody has accepted that being a Christian means to suffer? Go and ask true Christians.